service to God's people. And what I join Mr. Rebel, the words of Mr. Peter Gould, and a round of applause to Peter for all his work and all his work. I join him in thanking the entire Gesu family, the Board of Trustees, Mr. Carter, Sister Ellen, the entire administration, faculty, staff, the students, and their families. It takes a village to raise up children. I thank you all. I also want to thank the Gala Committee and all those who worked very hard to make this evening a reality. I thank you for coming here tonight and the sacrifice you made to be part of this evening. To my family, my friends, my colleagues, I thank you for your presence and your support and your love for me. I also want to recognize all the educators in the room this evening. If you are in education, just wave your hand. College, high school, elementary school. We're a great ministry. And I know many of you are involved in urban education. And so I thank you for your commitment to the city of Philadelphia and to God's children. To my friends, colleagues at St. Martin Porres Catholic School, the Sal Academy, and so many others who are here tonight. It's never about competition, is it? We stand together to believe that these young people are not problems to be solved, but a gift to be shared. Mr. Carter was correct in saying that when he contacted me and asked me to accept this great honor, I said no. And I kept saying no. I've always been taught, to whom much has been given, much is expected. Mm-hmm. And for me, as a priest and as a Christian man, there's one thing I see, and this I long for, to dwell in God's house. The Lord has said to me when I cross over, well done. Well done. Good and faithful servant, come on in and take your seat. But the more I thought about it, and the more Sister Ellen poked me, I accepted it conditionally. One, I felt that my presence tonight would inspire someone to give a little bit, whatever you have to offer, your time, your talent, your treasure, whatever you can do. If I can do it, so can you. The people here tonight were very blessed in many ways. You can give back. You can touch the life of a young person and make a difference. I hope my presence tonight inspires someone to say, yes, I'll do the same. But finally, and more importantly, I said yes because of you. Stand up straight. Put your chin up. Put your hands to your side. Some people will see you and be afraid of you, the young black man. Some people will see you and clutch their pocketbook or their wallet in fear. I don't see that. They don't see that. They see in you great hope, great potential, and great life. You put your tie, you wear it proudly. Because one day you take your resume and go to a job interview. You stand up straight, you put your belt on, and walk like you've got somewhere to go. Mm. You continue to believe in how good you are and the light that's inside of you. And if I've done anything, young men, I hope I've inspired you. There's nothing you can't accomplish. Nothing you can't accomplish. If you work hard, if you allow your mind to control your body, if you allow yourself to be the very best man you can be, if you listen to your parents, because you've got some good parents at home, and all the other adults who care about you, there's nothing you can't accomplish. And perhaps one day, this might be yours. It's only because of you that I accept this medal. And next week, Thursday, I'll see you in class.
Yes!